Hello students, in this video we will discuss one very important question regarding social science history part, the Indianization of civil services in India during the British rule. This is the question, and the question is very important. If you watch this video on YouTube, please subscribe my channel Indra Coaching Classes, like this video and comment if you have any question regarding social science, English grammar and English book. English textbook question, please write your question in the comment box. I will try to satisfy you. Thank you. It is important for class 9, Indianization of Indian civil service services during the British rule. You know, the company rule started in India, and on the administrative post only the British posted. The British people were appointed on administrative post. The Indians were not given chance to hold such administrative post. What were the reason? You see, through the Act of Charter Act of 1793, the civil service posts were reserved for the covenant servicemen of the company. Those servicemen had to sign one affidavit declaring that they would not involve in their personal trade and business in India during their service. They also declared that they would not accept any gift or any present from anyone during their services. On this basis, they were given, the British were given administrative post. And you know, Lord Cornwallis, he had very discriminatory attitude regarding Indians. He said that Indians were not accustomed with the modern system of administration, therefore they should not be given administrative post. See his views. The Indians were not accustomed with modern system of administration, therefore they should not be given administrative post. This was one view. Next, he said, if Indians were given administrative post, it would go against the interest of the British East India Company. This was his view, discriminatory view, who was famous for Cornwallis Code. Next, you see, liberal English thinkers were also there. They wanted that the Indians should be given administrative post, and provisions was made to determine the eligibility of Indian for the civil service post. But the board of directors opposed the proposal of the Act of 1833. Even after that, the post of deputy magistrate and deputy collector were created, and these posts were created for the Indians to give entry to the Indians in the administrative, in the administration of the country. Next, you see, in one act was passed in 1853, and the government. This act directed the government to hold competitive examination for civil services, and Indians were also given opportunity to enter the exam. But since the examinations were held in London, therefore a very few students appeared in the examination. You know, after the revolt of 1857, in the year 1858, Queen's proclamation was declared. In this proclamation, the Queen of England declared that the Indians would be given government services without any discrimination. There will be no discrimination on any basis for the appointment of Indians on administrative post or in government job. And you know, therefore one committee was formed to hold ICS examination you see, and the committee was to suggest regarding holding the ICS examination in India. But this suggestion of the committee was not implemented. Up to 1865, the upper age limit for the Indian candidates to appear in the ICS examination was 22 years. But in 1866, it was reduced to 19, you see, it was reduced to 21 years. Satyendranath Tagore became the first Indian to qualify ICS examination in the year 1864. And Anand Ram Barua became the first Assamese to qualify ICS examination in the year 1872. This was the achievement during those days. Lord Lytton also did not have a soft corner for the Indians regarding ICS examination. During his tenure, he reduced the upper age limit for the Indians from 21 to 19 years. S.N. Banerjee raised his voice against the move of the Viceroy Lord Lytton, and finally the upper age limit was increased to 22 years. This was what happened. Next, you see, Public Service Commission. In 1886, Lord Dufferin formed Public Service Commission and to discuss the whole issue of Indian Civil Services examination, this Public Service Commission was formed. He also formed Aitchison Commission, and this commission, Aitchison Commission, approved the split of Civil Service Department. These three parts, the Civil Service Department was split into three parts, and you see, Aitchison Commission approved this. What were the three parts? Imperial Indian Civil Service Commission, Provincial Civil Service Commission, and Subordinate Civil Service Commission. Imperial Civil Service Commission, the posts of Imperial Civil Service Commission was reserved for the British, and other two, the Provincial Civil Service Commission and Subordinate Civil Service Commission, were open for the Indians. Then this way, Montague Chelmsford Report. Montague Chelmsford Report, you see, declared that civil service examination should be held both in India and in England simultaneously. It also declared that one third post, administrative post, should be filled up by the Indians. And then Lee Commission was formed. Lee Commission was formed in 1923. Lee Commission was formed in 1923, and this commission implemented the recommendation of Montague Chelmsford report. It also proposed for the formation of Civil Service Commission in India. In 1935, the Government of India Act was passed, and India was to be made a federal state, and later Federal Civil Service Commission and Provincial Civil Service Commission were formed. Later, after 1947, the old system of recruitment for civil services were, you see, removed, and new system has been started. Thank you. I think you will understand this note, you will understand this answer. You watch this video, like this video, subscribe my channel. Thank you. Have a nice time.